American Urban Radio Networks.
I'm worried about
her. Ain't nothing to be worried about.
Like all black leaders, you have a bullseye on your back, and today it just got bigger.
But I ain't no black leader. Not yet.
And how you not a black leader? The vice president was just talking about you on the TV. Baby, you have to understand. With the Panthers, it wasn't that we had guns or black leather. It was because of our message. We were transforming minds. They are gonna come after you with everything you love. They gonna give you the tools that you need to destroy yourself.
No, Tupac was very, very opinionated. He was very vocal. He felt like his voice mattered, and he always wanted to be heard. So throughout this film, you know, what we did was we made sure that he was heard, not anything else, you know. And so he would be most proud that, you know, somebody stood up and fought for his voice. This is actually his voice, his point of view, you know, with no other hands in it, you know, so to speak. So he would be most proud about the fact that he's here and he's being heard correctly for what he really fought for.
Producer LT Hutton knows this journey very well. He was with Tupac from day one when he got signed to Death Row Records.
To thine own self, be true.
Demetrius Shipp Jr. makes his acting debut playing Tupac Shakur, beating out 4,000 hopefuls. But it didn't matter that Shipp looks enough like Tupac to frighten most people. He still worked hard to prepare for the role.
Looking like Tupac still wasn't enough. You had to prepare.
Right.
Big time. Tell me about that. How did you go about it?
Just watching a lot of footage on Tupac. You know, there's a lot of stuff on YouTube that you can watch. You know, so for me, it was just about watching that all day, every day, just trying to get the mannerisms down as much as possible, as well as when I got with my coach, we studied his life and, you know, from childhood to, you know, his demise, all in, you know, trying to get into the mind, the world as best as possible.
I'm sitting here looking at you and it is almost frightening. You know, I did his very first television interview.
Wow.
I don't know if you knew that.
I did not know that.
Your parents were in the Black Panther Party. Mm-hmm. That was kind of like their job.
Yeah, it was my mother was in the Black Panther Party. She was like at a high position, which was like unheard of because, of course, there was sexism, even in the Panthers. Mm-hmm. So, and my stepfather at the time, Matu Shakur, he was also like a well-known, like revolutionary, true. All of my roots to the struggle are real deep.
And those roots started with Afeni Shakur.
So I spent quite a few hours with her one day, but in 2009 it was. And we talked. It was a very interesting conversation. I wanted to talk, of course, about Tupac, and she just turned the conversation to me. Where was I from? What drove me to be a filmmaker? What did my mother do for a living? Those types of things. At the moment, I didn't quite understand it, but I understand that she probably got thousands of conversations with people about Pac, but she's never was able to have conversations with the people that loved her son to understand what that love is about. So we shared some moments together, and it was very interesting for me to be able to recall those things when shooting the film and being able to understand her plight, her pain. And she still wears, you know, at the time, she still wore the pain of Pac passing and not having her son.
Afeni wasn't the only woman who played a key role in Tupac's life. Jada Pinkett, yes, Jada Pinkett Smith as we know her today, was his childhood friend from Baltimore. They were both passionate about their craft and ended up in Hollywood at the same time as rising stars. Jada is played by Cat Graham.
Jada!
I want as much of her amazing essence to come through in this film, and I hope that I could even put in a smidgen of what this woman has not only just meant to me, but a lot of other black women and girls and the industry. You know, she's kind of our like beacon of hope, you know, that you can be a producer and you can be a musician and you can be all of these things, and you don't have to be put into a box, and you can be an activist and not be afraid of anyone. And that is incredibly important at this time.
You are my heart in human form. A friend I can never replace.
California yet? You already going soft on me.
Oh, I'm going soft?
So soft.
You got the tears in your eyes. The tears flow, and I'm getting soft.
It isn't a coincidence that Tupac's story is finally being told in a feature film. The revolution may not be televised, but it will probably come to a theater near you. I'm Tanya Hart. See you next time.
Let's get it.